Skyboat Media presents Shattered Skies, Book 1, Heartborn, by Terry Maggert. This book is read by Gabrielle de Cuir. Chapter 1, The Leap. The relentless wind cooled his skin as he mustered the courage to jump. It was a long way to fall, and he'd been poised on the edge for nearly an hour. It wasn't fear that kept him rooted to the spot, but the effort of reaching through time to see what consequences his action might bring. To think of leaving was akin to dropping a boulder in the pool of his own history. There was no way to foresee what the ripples might cause, or the waves, since this would make waves, not ripples. It was all an undiscovered thing. No one had done what he meant to do, at least not in the memory of his house. Under the points of his boots, featureless mist curled away to reveal an enticing glimpse of color and life so unlike his own home. Gray, he thought. I'm so very tired of all the gray in these clouds. The longer he looked at the myriad of colors below, the more acute his hunger to see what mysteries rolled beneath him, unknown and vibrant. The land looked like a fairy tale made real, its hills and rivers gleaming like a promise in the early morning light. The sheer distance and appeal of it all clutched at his chest like a physical thing, making him cover his heart. His body fizzed with excitement and fear, and he liked it.
You won't go, you know.
His brother's voice was bored to the point of insolence, a tone he'd perfected from years of practice. Like others who kept their face an impassable mask, he'd lost much of the joy in his life, if ever he knew it. Brother Garrick appeared from the sullen gray mist that hid the secret columns and towers of their home. Walking toward Keiron, a smile quirked at the cruel lips, so unlike his own.
We've already been to the edge of the scrying pool. You won't go. It is known to us.
A look flickered across the impassive face, something ugly and hot. His control was slipping. That was new, as was his belief that he was equal to their parents, or older siblings at that. Yes, I will. Keiron's voice sounded small in the silence. Even the wind died out of respect for what he was about to say, and if his resolve held, what he would then do. A sad shake of the perfect head said that was a lie. Garrick was beautiful to the point of distraction. His pupils were nearly colorless, in a face framed with fine blonde hair that called sunlight to mind, so different from his brother. Garrick was light, while Keiron was dark, with skin golden from the sun and eyes the black of a starless night. A long, aquiline nose gave him a regal quality that Garrick, for all his perfection, could not possess. His hair was curled and ebony to the point of being liquid, a black mass that he pushed back with irritation at Garrick's verbal assault. Keiron was lean and tall, and in the stages of bloom where men first leave boyhood behind when they are no longer concerned with a young man's things. Garrick spoke again, substituting arrogance for wisdom.
No. There is no escaping that which is past, even if you were to...
A swift cut of Keiron's hand broke the thought. His brother looked shocked, then amused, and then angry. He didn't like being spoken to that way.
I can, and I will. I know how to shift the light of days, and I know when to do it, too.
Really?
A secret of that size? And you, a minor son.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.